Back in the day when there were no movies, no internet, and no phones, long, long ago in an old place called Japan, Oda Nobunaga, the great unifier, was born. Oda Nobunaga was born in 1534 in a small place called Owari Province. His father, Nobuhide, was a minor feudal lord of the land. In 1551, Oda lost respect and trust from his father's retainers after he acted irrationally at his father's funeral. The retainers started to favor Nobuyuki, his brother. However, Nobunaga solved this problem by assassinating him. Oda reclaimed his place as true heir by subduing those who went against him. His first goal was to expand and strengthen his power. His first target, all of Owari.
The first battle that got him recognized was the Battle of Okehazama. On June 21st, 1560, Oda received news that Imagawa and his 25,000 men were on their way to Kyoto, the capital of Japan. The next day, he got word that Matsudaira Motoyasu had captured one of Oda's forts, Fort Marune. Imagawa decided to camp and celebrate their up-and-coming victory at Dengaku-hazama, a gorge that was unfavorable for maneuverability. Coincidentally, it was also a place Nobunaga knew well as a boy. On June 22nd, while Imagawa's men were celebrating, Oda and his 2,000 men succeeded to land a surprise attack on Imagawa. That day, by chance or fate, a violent rainstorm rolled into the area. This left the army drunk and in chaos, a perfect target for Oda's army, who had used the storm as cover to attack their forces. The battle was important for two reasons. If Nobunaga had been defeated, Imagawa would have made his way into Kyoto, and one can only think of the result. The second was that one of Imagawa's rear vassals, Matsudaira Motoyasu, was later to be known as Tokugawa Ieyasu, one of Oda's most trusted allies. His next step was to make friends with Kai Mikawa. In 1561, Nobunaga made a pact with Tokugawa Ieyasu. Now, the only provinces standing between him and Kyoto were Mino and Omi. Oda made an alliance with the Aisai family of Omi by marrying off his sister, Oichi, to Asai Nagasana. At first, Oda tried to conquer Mino by marrying himself to Saito Dosen's daughter, but that proved to be a failure when in 1566, Dosen was betrayed and killed by his own son. From that moment on, Mino was against Nobunaga. However, Nobunaga was not easily discouraged and managed to overcome his problem with the Saito stronghold by bribing the warriors under him. It is also mainly due to Hideyoshi, who suggested to Oda that it would be strategically favorable to build a fortification between the Kizu and Nagara rivers. By doing so, Oda was able to capture their main castle without trouble. Therefore, he was finally able to reach his goal of conquering Mino, clearing a path for Kyoto. In 1567, the younger brother of the previous shogun, Yoshiaki, requested that Nobunaga help him build up the Ashikaga Bakufu, the main government at that time. This gave Oda the authority behind his actions and made the idea of attacking him less appealing. This was also presented on his seal, which said, "Rule the empire by force." The only opposition he now faced was Izu Province, but Nobunaga easily defeated them in 1568. He then made his way into Kyoto on November 9, 1568. Also on December 28th, Yoshiaki became the new shogun. At that time, his goal was to get the Ji Samurai type on his side because they were not under the control of chieftains and would be a great asset to his army. He was already on a rocky relationship with the shogun, but it started to worsen day by day. Finally, it was enough. In 1569, he moved a large force into Kyoto to intimidate the shogun and to announce Aizai's defeat. He wrote a letter in 1570 that told his representatives that he made Yoshiaki accept 5 oaths that made him powerless. After that ordeal, Nobunaga had great respect towards the shogun. But Yoshiaki was disposed of when Nobunaga found out that he was negotiating with his arch-nemesis, Shingen Takeda, in 1573. A while after, he started focusing on rebuilding Kyoto on a large scale and on the politics of Kyoto. He limited Daimyo's power over villagers by having them pay some of their tax to himself. He also established castle towns as commercial centers for trade and removed road tolls to increase domestic trade. Finally, he pioneered the use of surveying the quantity and quality of land to create the foundation of the early modern political system. Along with creating a better economy, he also revolutionized military power. He built stone forts to go against newly added firearms and built warships with iron cladding. He also positioned samurai according to skill, not blood, and separated the samurai from working class by disarming the commoners and only permitting samurai to carry weapons. A few years back, Nobunaga had encountered shipwrecked Portuguese soldiers who, at the time of the crash, were carrying firearms with them. Oda offered to buy the harquebuses from them, and in exchange, he would let them spread Christianity on his territory. This event was caused and created by many events. Oda was against Buddhism because they were allied with his enemies and were a constant annoyance to him. He welcomed Christianity because he thought it would help damper down Buddhism. Nobunaga was so against Buddhism that he went to war with them from 1570 to 1580. In the process, he was branded cruel and brutal because he killed anyone he found in the monasteries, even women and children. Another result was that Christianity was finally introduced to Japan. By bringing guns to Japan, Nobunaga was able to explore the use of guns in warfare. In exchange, he made new tactics that were never tried before and won battles easily. But soon, other daimyos noticed and started using guns in their own battles. The result was a total change on how wars are fought. At last, he encountered betrayal. While Oda was on his way to enforce Hideyoshi, whose castle was under siege, he stopped at Hanoji Temple. That night, on June 21, 1581, Aketsu Mutsuhide, a trusted friend, told the enemy army where Oda was staying. The army attacked and surrounded his forces, forcing him into Hanoji Temple. Having nowhere to run, Oda decided to die the honorable way and committed seppuku. By his death, he was able to unite one-third of Japan, end the Ashikaga shogunate, revolutionize warfare, introduce Christianity, and raise the economy of Japan. The next heir of Japan would be Tokugawa Ieyasu, who followed in his footsteps and also united one-third of Japan.